Hello friends, welcome in Python video series. In previous video tutorial, we have learned how to create our own iterator class, right? And there we have seen we have to define iter as well as next function, right? And afterwards, we have seen we were able to generate a number starting from 1 till 50, right? And that of you have to define at least minimum two functions. But in this video tutorial, we are going to see what is generator, right? So I'm going to create a separate file. I would say my gen. Yeah. So here I'm going to create first of all a function, right? And I would say my gen. Okay. And let's say this function returns some value. Then how you return some value, let's say I would write return 10. So, and here I'm going to call this guy, this function I'm going to call, right? Let's say I'm going to call this function, sorry. I'm going to call this function, let's say, I say my gen, or let's say I'm going to call values equal to my gen. And this value, I'm going to print over here. Right, if I run, then this function is sorry, previous class is running, so this value is going to return and 10 gets printed. Means once you return some value, that means your function is going to terminate, right? So when we talk about the generator, instead of a return statement, we give something is called yield. So you have to use yield keyword. Now if I run, you'll see output would be a little different. It is returning generator object, right? So generator basically internally uses iterator itself. So when you define your own iterator, then you have to define two functions, it, er, and next. But if you use generator, generator basically implicitly creates a iterator for you, right? Let me prove that one. So here I have one yield function, but if you define a function which will basically return a generator, then you can have many yield keyword you can give, and you can return different value from here, right? So here I'm returning four values, and you can call something is called next, right? Next method you can call. So if I run, then let's see, it is returning 10, right? Let's say if I call next function on generator, so now it is returning as generator, as I have shown you. So now if I call four times next, then it is returning four value, right? Four different value what yields returns, right? But if you call beyond of that, then this is going to throw an exception. Let me show you. So it will throw a stop iterator exception, right? What you can see over here. So even though if you have an iterable object, and if you're calling a next function more than how many elements you have in iterator, then this is going to call, this is going to throw stop iteration exception, right? But anyhow, this behaves like, say, this function behaves like a, when I call it, then this behaves like a iterator, right? So when you have a generator, when your function returns yield, right, instead of return method, it is using yield, right, yield keyword to return many values, then it works like a generator. Now here, instead of calling next method every time, I can use for loop, right? For I will say I in values, right? And I can print all the values which is going to return by this generator. Let me show you. If I run, then here you can see it is returning all those values. So basically your yield, basically this function or generator basically works like a iterator internally, right? That's how iterator works. Now I'm going to modify this function. I'm going to take a use case. Let's say I'm going to return a number starting from 1 to 5 or 1 to 10. There I want to calculate cube of every number. Cube of every number. So what I'll do, I'll start with 1, n equal to 1. And I will use while loop. I'm not going to use for loop, because for loop is internally using iterator itself. So here I'm going to use for loop, and I would less than 5, right? Less than equal to 5 I'm going to write, and inside this I will write a function n, or I will say cube equal to n into n into n. This is cube, right? And instead of return statement, I will write yield cube, right? And afterwards I will write n equal to n plus 1. That's it. Now if you, so first of all, this is yield, this is not a basically return, right? Now if I run, then it is going to return a cube of number starting from 1 till 5. Let me show you. So if I run it, then it is showing some name error. Let me check out. Okay, sorry, there should be n, right? If I run, then here you can see it is returning a cube of 1, cube of 2, cube of 3, cube of 4 and cube of 5, right? It is working perfectly fine. How it is working internally? So basically we have started from number 1 less than equal to 5, then this will go inside this and this will calculate the cube of 1, and whenever it finds yield keyword, then it will return, but it will save the basically current status. So next time when you call, that incremented value is going to check again this condition. Again this will calculate the cube of next, and again yield is going to return cube of next number. So that's how basically it is working. So anyway, my intention is to show you, whenever you create a function with yield, that means this function is going to basically use internally iterator. So you don't need to really define your iter as well as next function, how we have seen in the previous video tutorial. To implement our own iterator, we need to implement this kind of function, right? These kind of two functions, right? Now thing is that, what's the benefit of using a generator? So here let me tell you, sometimes let's say if you want to read some data from a file system or from database, right? Then sometimes you are not interested to read entire data in one go, right? Let's say your database contains 1 million record, and if you want to read 1 million record into your basically program, then you may run out of memory, right? Instead, what you can do, you want to read data in different chunks or different batch size. In that scenario, or if you want to run some data from the file system, you don't want to read entire data, right? Say a file size is 1 GB, and if you want to run, if you want to read all data in one go, then you might face out of memory issue. So instead of reading entire data from the file system in one go, you can read data in different chunks, maybe in the MB, 10 MB in every batch, right? In every read operation, you want 10 MB of data from the file system, and in that way, in that case, you can use a generator, right? So that's all I wanted to say in this video tutorial, guys. Big thank you for watching this video, and see you there in the next video tutorial.